Hey y'all. A lot of people think that eukaryotic cells are just kind of these amorphous, squishy, disorganized bags of goo. But I'm here to tell you, nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, most eukaryotic cells contain a complex network of tubes and filaments that provide the structural scaffolding on which your organelles, macromolecular complexes, vesicles, etc., are hung and organized and able to move around inside the cell, and we call this collection of tubes and filaments the cytoskeleton. There are three essential components of the cytoskeleton. The first of these are microtubules. Microtubules are heterodimers, meaning two different monomers, alpha tubulin and beta tubulin, assemble into a dimer, which then further polymerizes to give us our microtubule. Because of the asymmetry that we see here on this face of the beta tubulin molecule, as the dimers stack up on top of each other, they're going to form this kind of spiral staircase or helix. And in fact, it takes 13 heterodimers to make a single turn of the helix. If you were to look over here at this single microtubule that we see in this structure, which we're going to talk about in a second, you would see that there are 13 individual heterodimers poking out in this cross section. Microtubules, while the largest of the components of the cytoskeleton, are still only 24 nanometers across. So, in the world of ultrastructure, that's actually kind of big. There are two main assemblages of microtubules that you will see in eukaryotic cells. The first of these, the one I've been drawing on in this transmission electron micrograph on the left, is called an axoneme. The axoneme is a collection of microtubules in a very particular pattern, which we call the 9 plus 2 arrangement. We call it this, not surprisingly, because there are nine microtubular doublets arranged in the outer circle, plus two singlet microtubules in the middle. The axoneme forms the main core structure of the motile organelles, flagella and cilia. If you look at a spermatozoan, that is the swimming mature sperm cell, you will find an axoneme running down the length of that tail. That's what allows it to move. If you look in the cilia found, say, in your upper respiratory tract or in the female reproductive system, you would find axonemes inside those cilia, which allow them to move and impart current in fluids. The other main microtubular arrangement that we find in the eukaryotic cell is the centriole. While similar to the axoneme, it does have some distinct differences. The centriole has what we call a 9 plus 0 arrangement, so there are nine sets of microtubules in the ring around here. The other thing that's different is that if you look carefully, there are three microtubules in each set of microtubules, so it's nine microtubular triplets instead of doublets in the centriole. You probably know centrioles from cell division, specifically from mitosis or nuclear division. And that's because the centrioles form what are called microtubular organizing centers, or MTOCs. These are going to organize the microtubules that become the spindle fibers that are actually going to separate chromosomes during mitosis and facilitate equal splitting of DNA between the two daughter cells. Microtubules are the largest of cytoskeletal component. The smallest are microfilaments. Unlike microtubules, microfilaments are monopolymers of the protein actin. They are microfilaments, they are the smallest component because they are 5 to 7 nanometers wide. Compare that to 24 in a microtubule. Microfilaments are going to do all sorts of important things for our body, not limited to, but including muscle contraction. Microfilaments form the thin filaments inside muscle cells. Cytoplasmic streaming, if you look and see organelles, vesicles especially, other small particles being moved inside a cell, that's typically facilitated by microfilaments. The formation of an endocytic vesicle is caused by the assembly and disassembly of microfilaments at the plasma membrane. And while microtubules are responsible for separating chromosomes during mitosis, it's actually actin microfilaments that divide the parent cell into the two daughter cells during cytokinesis. Microtubules are the largest cell, or the largest filament in the cell. Microfilaments are the smallest in the cell, and in between them, we have the cryptically named intermediate filament. Intermediate filaments come in about two dozen varieties. For our sake, the most important are keratins, which you know quite well because these are the filamentous proteins that give your hair and nails their structure, Desmin, which is really important in muscle tissue, it's also important in certain cell-to-cell junctions, so how we hold two cells together. And finally, the one we're looking at here at the end of the blue arrow, neurofilaments. Neurofilaments provide structure to neural appendages, such as the dendrites on these Purkinje cells in the image on the right. Now, intermediate filaments come in a number of varieties, and we'll cross those bridges when we get there. But for now, just know that any cytoskeletal structure that is intermediate in size between a microfilament and a microtubule is going to be classified as an intermediate filament. Well, that's all for now. Have fun, study hard, see you later.